A survivor story by Nate Stevenson. We all had that moment in life where we sit and relax and wonder, how in the hell did this happen? I thought I was at a peak in my life, smoking good, drinking good, partying good, finding ways to call off sick to get a quick fix by booking trips. As many will say, I was enjoying life until I started noticing fluent migraines happening. That's when the fun stopped. I felt worse than a track star in the blocks that didn't run because he didn't hear that gun pop. I don't like popping meds, so after those 800 ibuprofen prescriptions stopped working, my suspicion was just a bug drop in my big ass head. The first doctor gave me a prediction of what he thought it was instead, and that's when the anger kicked in because they didn't even take blood or do a test. I went off on him for nothing. What's worse, he was right. And when I started my process in the middle of 33 radiation treatments, 3 chemotherapies, and during those lonely times at night, I noticed 60 pounds gone from throwing up at night. And by day, hearing in one ear was better than Michael Jordan's fade away as it fades away. That's when my faith got iffy. First time I ain't want anybody in my face. Even started having arguments with my first love, Taste. When that started, my love for Taste departed, which was a hard pill to swallow. But my grandma always said what's meant to be will always work itself out, and that's the memo I live by and follow. My life always been on a roller coaster, so a broken heart and weight loss just made me want to slow down. Felt the spirit that made me bow my head down. That's when I knew God was real. So I put it in God's hand, gained faith again. All of a sudden, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadows of death, I will feel no evil. It's all in my brain again. At that point, all doubts went away. I turned fearless and the fight came back. Dropping tears or taking my own life could have been part of the agenda, but wasn't part of the plan. Instead, I keep a smile on, because when I look in the mirror, I see an educated, attractive African-American that like to get his style on. I figured Taste wasn't around, so I had to pick myself up. Went back in the market, hit up a few wonderful women that would get my head right back on track, like with Inshore, who was smooth, non-acidic foods, she was proper, alkaline diets, was pure, yams with a side of red snapple, oh my, they was my crush, them two together made my adrenaline rush, and eventually with all them coming in my life, started to drive Taste nuts. She noticed I'd move on without her because she could see the weight gain in my face. That was part of the challenge. By the way, Taste back in my life now, so eating right and drinking right just keep me balanced. For anybody going through a bad relationship fight, I'm still fighting cancer, so it's only right that you stay focused because a bad relationship to your temple could only turn poison and won't last. I want everybody who's experiencing something tragic in life to remember one thing: that this too shall pass.